everybody. Today we're going to try and build a tremolo pedal, which I bought from AliExpress. It's a small company called Landtone, I think. I built a few of their pedals before. They've worked out to varying degrees. They have one drawback, where they basically give the worst instructions known to man. Basically a photocopy of a photocopy of a photocopy, but should be enough to help me through it. It comes packaged with everything you need to build a thing, I hope. The PCB here, everything's labeled, so it shouldn't be too hard to figure out. I also got a new tattoo. One thing I like about buying these cheap pedal kits is they give you nicely painted enclosures. I probably won't use this enclosure with this pedal. I might not even put it in an enclosure. I don't really have any need for a tremolo, I just thought it would be fun to build. But it's a nice gold painted enclosure for another project. Or this, I might put it in this. So, I'll start with the resistors and hope for the best. This part is pretty easy, you just basically plug in the bits where they're supposed to go. Everything is usually labeled pretty well. I'll probably just sort these first since they're all kind of loose. So now all of the resistors are situated. I'm a bit worried about some of them because the diagram and the circuit board are labeled. There's one that's labeled 1.2K, but the resistor seems to be labeled 12K. And the same with 2.2K, I think they give me a 22K but hopefully it's a mistake in labeling, or maybe I'm not reading it right. The handwriting is terrible on the resistors. It might not work at all because of it. Anyway, I think we'll move on to the capacitors. That is all of the capacitors and resistors in. So next we have some transistors. There's only three of them, shouldn't be too hard to figure out. Okay, so that's all the major components. Now for some of the hardware. The connectors and whatnot. Hate these pot covers. They look just really cheap. Actually, before I start doing that stuff, I might just solder in these in place. So now it's all soldered up with very dodgy solder joints, my trademark. Next step will be to add in switches and pots and input jacks and whatnot. So I think I might try and finish this up tomorrow. So now we'll start putting in the cables. One great thing about these kits is that it arrives with plenty of pre-cut cables, so you don't have to fiddle around with a big ream of wire. Just makes things a little bit handier. Okay, so that is all of the wiring as far as I can tell. The diagram does say there needs to be two other connections where you just jumper two parts, but the instructions are terrible and I can't really tell what's going on. It has an X through the wire as well, which I'm not sure if that means it was a mistake or what. But we'll plow ahead and see how it works. We'll put in the switch next. 3PDT, which I always forget. Not sure what that stands for. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of these ones where you mount the switch, the foot switch, onto the board. It's kind of a hassle, and it makes it harder to actually put the entire thing in an enclosure later. I think it's better just to hook it up with wires, but on this version, this is how they did it, so whatever. Right, so now the only thing I have left to do, I think, is this. I'll plug it in and see if it works then. Otherwise I might have to go back over the soldering joints. And I might have to do those extra jumper cables that I'm not sure if I have to do or not. The joys of random Chinese instructions that aren't translated.
Okay.
So that looks finished to me. The kit didn't provide enough cables to do this wire here, which is crossed out, and this jumper here, which is crossed out. So I'm going to assume that they're not needed and just try it out. Okay, so now I'm going to test it. I've got my Epiphone Les Paul Studio Gothic. Of one of my crappier guitars, but perfect for this anyway. And we're going to play it through what is undisputably the coolest amplifier ever built, or at least the coolest one I own, the Micro Crush, the Orange. That's pretty cool. I mean, it has controls for depth, volume, and speed. Sounds pretty good. It's all analog. Nice one. Not sure if I'll get any use out of it. might leave it as it is and play around for a while and decide later if I want to use an enclosure and actually put it on the pedal board. Still a good build, easy enough, even if the instructions weren't clear. Cheap as chips, I mean, I think it was 15 euro, so not bad. But thanks for watching. If you liked it, please like and subscribe. Again, I'll be doing more of these kind of videos, hopefully one a week. I have a few more pedals to build. A few more kits have arrived recently, so I have at least two more in the pipeline. And I'm sure I'll have some more on the way after. Thanks.